Namalsk, one of the most brutal maps in DayZ. Fighting against the elements, blizzards and frostbite, knowing that one bullet and you'll lose everything. I grinded through a ton of fights, storms, portals, cambers and more to complete the new suit from the latest content update, and it's awesome. But that'll unfold in the story. I first spawned like everyone else on the frozen shorelines. Hey, fat loot. I ran to the biggest city in the north of the map, Orkuta, but I didn't want to have to deal with the shenanigans and stacked players that head back to spawn locations to kill fresh spawns.
Stop.
You really worth it for some rags.
Not today, although it didn't take long before I was getting chased down. I was excited to crack on with the new content, so I grabbed some better clothes, food and supplies, and quickly made my way south.
Could really do with a gun, but I'm not hanging around.
Despite leaving the north in a hurry, I'd managed to get myself pretty geared. Not only that, I'd found a filament. I was going to be needing that to make the suit. It requires three in total, orange, blue and red, as well as some blueprints and a nat card from the submarine. The blueprints can be looted at the random red lifeboat spawns on Tara Island, and it just so happens that the filaments can be found there too, in industrial areas. On top of all of that, I'd also need a full MVC suit and gas mask, which I could get from the hospital. So I made my way there to try and find the rest.
Hello?
Nice try.
The blueprint. Finally, there's a red one. there it is.
Aha. No idea how big that group is, and I literally don't need anything. EpiPen, a solo's best friend. I left the fight as I didn't need anything and it wasn't worth staying. I also had everything to build the suit, except the keycard, but I wasn't quite ready to do that. You see, the suit has built-in NVGs and gas mask, but to use it needs the suit battery and air can, which only spawn in A3 and Lantia. As I was geared already, I decided it would make more sense to get them first, but it wasn't quite that easy. But before I could try and get them, I had to wait for an EVR storm so I could push the button in A2 and activate the portal. Christ, I'm a dumbass. Oh damn, I can't fall because of my leg. Maybe I'm too heavy. No! Oh, I know not to drag. What am I doing? That had all my filters in. I'm screwed. Thank you.
I didn't have much luck at A3. The only time I found both parts, this happened. Oh, hell yeah. Ladder campers, come on. I died 4 or 5 times at A2 and A3 and was getting frustrated at the long wait between storms. It's safe to say I underestimated this part of the mission. I did manage to snag an air canister which I stashed near the portal site at A1, which was away from my main one. My new plan would be to make the suit, get the air, then jump to A3 and hope to find a battery. But before all that, I still need to get the keycard from the submarine, so I respawned and got to work. You know what? Screw this kid. I'm gonna run back. Aha, it's me. Yeah, you like that? Sat up there on your roof? was a headshot. We'll grab a juice box and take a nap. Thing was on semi. Hello? Should have just waved. And that was it. With the keycard in my possession, I finally had all the parts to build the suit. I gathered some extra gear and went to dig up my stash along with the NPC suit I'd buried. I now needed to go back out onto the ice, find the oil rig where I can build the suit. Thank you. After all that running around, I'd finally built the suit. I still needed the air and batteries, so I picked up the Lantia locator from the oil rig and went to dig up my other stash with the air inside so I could wait out the next EVR storm at A2. I think there's a storm. Oh, hell yeah. Worth a try. You used to be able to run straight in if you were quick enough. Holy traces. I think that's a bear. Please don't be a squad. There goes a landmine. It goes crazy whenever a storm hits. Hey! Nice. Cleared this twice, but you never know. I should probably leave. I'm not gonna leave. I want to explore. think I made it angry. As I decided not to jump in the portal, I was trapped. My only way out was to kill myself or wait for someone else to open the portal again, and the chances of that were slim. I waited around for hours, and when I got fed up with that, I even tried some parkour to escape. That didn't work, at least not what I could find. I made the unexpected jump to A3 when someone opened the portal as I was grabbing my stash. The timing was perfect. I hadn't banked on needing food and water to survive. I lasted for as long as I can by smashing saline bags for hydration and topping up on air as needed. Finally, my food hit red, but then something unexpected happened. That must be the storm. There's hope. Yo, someone's coming. One person? That's fine. Just come to Lantia. Stuck here. Help me, step bro. I was dead, but I wasn't quite done. I was trapped in Lantia for hours, and I must have checked every nook and cranny I could find, and something caught my eye in one of the documents. A class 3 sandstorm, major disruptions, lightning, really? All because the portal was held open longer. I didn't show it earlier, but I also found a new controller in the lab, and I suspected they were linked. I was curious, and as per the intro to this video, I fought through blizzards, I fought against frostbite, I fought player after player just to do it all again. This time, I knew the layout of Lantia, so I jumped in and went straight to Theta to check the lab, and then jumped back to reactivate the portal with the new flow controller in place. What happened next was pretty mind-blowing. Okay, so you go in here, and let's see what happens. What about the cage? Oh, that's new. Definitely made it angry now. Holy crap, there's the tremors. So cool. So scared, I did it all again. I'll see you in the next one. If you made it to the end, please do consider subscribing. It really helps me out. You could also hit a like or check out one of these videos as well.